robot is sore loser.
Source 2.
Maximum Ogredrive.
Snappy.
Drizzle.
To get our last place in the grand final. First off, we have Clause 2. Did you have many repairs after that last fight, Chris?
Not too much. We've just managed to get them all fixed in time. We had a wheel that was jammed up. We've freed that, and the Claws aren't looking too happy at that after the fight, but they are working.
Good luck. Tom, you lost to Captain Doom.
Unsurprisingly, really.
How are you feeling for the Rumblebee? Last chance to get back in the grand final. Is it all working and ready?
Yeah, pretty much. All ready, all good to go. I think I've probably got the nastiest weapon here, so we'll see what happens.
Hopefully there'll be lots of carnage and devastation. Sam, are you ready for this?
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
How are you looking after your wheel came off to Rev 2?
It did. He pulled one of the gearboxes out to replace that. We've put a new saw on, so it's nice and sharp. So should go through everything.
Good luck. Craig, Snappy lost to Limpet. Bit sad about that, but never mind. Last chance to get back in. How are you feeling about this incredibly chaotic five-way rumble?
He's too much of a friendly boy for all this.
No, he's not. That's a facade, I think, Craig.
Look at him.
He wants to win. He wants to win.
He wants love.
Alex, sore loser. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling about this fight?
Pretty good. I've just given up on the sore idea. It's a vert on the end of an arm.
So you've replaced the spinner then?
Yeah, because it was pretty wrecked after the fight with K2. I had a spare arm made up with this two-tooth disc on. So we'll see how that
works. Yeah, because the previous one had multiple teeth, six teeth. Okay, and this one's only got two.
Yeah, for better engagement.
Well, good luck. Good luck to everybody. Let's get this rumble going.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
Oh, this one is going to be exciting, and I don't think which robot knows which one to go for first. In comes Clause 2 there, attacking Saw Loser.
We've got five robots all ready to go for this.
Oh!
Already, Drizzle beating the living daylights out of Snappy.
That was an impressive attack there. From the mini monsoon machine.
But a wheel's come off a Drizzle. That's basically going to leave him trapped in the center. He can still move, but not as effectively.
Tom, stop destroying your own robot. Oh, sparks flying there in the top corner of your picture.
Maximum Ogredrive bringing down the saw on the side of Saw Loser. There's some alliteration there. Oh, going right into the side of it. Look at that.
How ironic is that? Sawing through Saw Loser.
I think he's actually gotten in and damaged some of the drive mechanism. It doesn't appear to be driving correctly on one side. It's the opposite side to where that saw was, but it could be anything. Now trying to move in on
release
Snappy.
Release tire now active. Down goes the pit. Sparks fly again from Maximum Ogredrive.
Clause 2 just staying out of the way, trying to win this by not getting too much damage, I think.
Okay. There's Drizzle desperately trying to move out of its own circumference there. Middle of your picture, Maximum Ogredrive. They're back in for another attack. But Snappy almost into the pit there. Clause 2 backs away.
Snappy's lost drive on one side. You can see how he's having to sort of crab.
Oh, Maximum Ogredrive!
No!
A massive push there from Clause 2. This is one of our favourites. They're out. What an awesome push there from Clause 2.
Felicity Sorry there, 13 years old, and demonstrating why you should never count her out of a situation. She may not have the most offensive robot, but the drive power is exceptional.
There goes the count on Saw Loser.
Eliminated.
We've lost Saw Loser there. Ref Tim moving them out the way.
Are any of these machines still functioning with full drives?
I believe Clause 2 is actually. Yeah, Clause 2 is the only one functioning normal.
They need to avoid that spinning weapon there.
Power down your weapon. You're out.
Drizzle has been counted out.
Oh!
And that's Snappy charging in on Drizzle just at the last second there as he was spinning down. I wonder if that damage is going to be critical.
Snappy. They've got Clause 2 up onto a piggyback toward the pit. Toward devastation.
No.
we unentangle them?
They have to be very careful here. Oh, good skill.
There we go.
Driving, but Clause 2 back down off the top.
Snappy ramming in on Clause 2. This has now turned into fully a pushing match.
Oh, you can tell they want this.
The question's going to rise as we come into the last 10 seconds.
Oh,
oh no! Right in the last second!
As the seconds tick down, Snappy snapped the victory.
You came so close. I mean, we... ultimately, you were put in the pit, so it doesn't go to the judges. Do you think maybe if it had gone to the judges, you'd have had it, maybe?
Snappy was rolling around on one wheel, so was Drizzle and Sawpoint, so I think we would have had it, and we put Sam in the pit as well, so I think we would have had it.
Yeah, you did. You got rid of Ogredrive. You've been fantastic, but this is where it ends. Are you proud of how you've done?
I am over the moon with my baby girl. She has been fantastic.
Yeah, she has, hasn't she? Can we have a massive hand for Clause 2, please? Absolutely brilliant. It looked to be going so well for you. You were getting some really, really good attacks. I think you've cut straight through the top of Saw Loser. I think Alex was saying you cut a wire, and that was it. That was them gone. And then you ended up in the pit. What happened?
I sort of did all the work. I wanted Saw Loser out of the way, so I waited to get a chance on him. It was just careless driving. I went straight up with a wedge right next to the pit.
Yeah, that never ends well. Are you happy with how you've done in this competition, though?
Yeah, it's performed really well. It's just my driving that's let down at the end of the day, but it's been really good, so.
Excellent. We're going to see you next time.
Yeah, definitely.
Wonderful. Everybody give it up for Maximum Ogredrive!
Alex, come here.
So you've got a fearsome weapon on this thing. You just didn't really get a chance to show it off in this fight, did you?
No, not that much. Sam had a hold me for quite a bit of it.
He's put quite a gouge in that, hasn't he?
Like right there,
straight
through all of my speed controllers. Well, not all of them. One of them was still working.
But that's not going to help you drive, is it?
No.
Are you happy with how it's gone? This is your first time competing in about 18 years. Have you enjoyed it?
Yeah, it's been amazing. It's been amazing.
Can we have you back next time? Because I'm sad to see this robot go.
Yeah, sure.
Sure, definitely.
Wonderful. Yeah. Right, can we give it up for Saw Loser, please? Right, before we start, can we have a big hand? The weapon worked for the whole fight! You lost, like, how did you lose that wheel? Do you know?
Yeah, I think they're held on by, like, little grub screws, and I think it came out or something, but the rest of it's okay, so, yeah.
Excellent. You got a couple of big hits in there. That's got to be worth it, right?
No, I'm happy. I think that might be my longest ever fight with this robot, so...
Can we have a hand for that? Drizzle, wait, a largely untested robot before you got it in here.
Completely untested.
Are you happy with how it's gone?
I'm a lot happier after seeing that. Yeah, you know, I think that fight in particular really makes it all worth it because it was a bit of a rough start, but yeah. I'm honestly really, really happy with how it's gone.
Wonderful. Yeah.
It's a good fight. It's good.
It really was, wasn't it? Can we give it up for Drizzle? How's this feel then, Craig?
Oops.
Well, because now you got to fight again.
Yeah, it wasn't meant to do this well.
I mean, you seem to be having driving problems, but you managed to get claws in the pit in the end.
Yeah, one of my light strips, one of the jazzy light strips, came off and was jamming up on my wheels, high centering me. So I'll get those secured a bit better for the next time.
You're in the final now, so this is it. This is do or die. Can we have a big hand for your final grand finalist, Snappy?
It's your boy!
I'm here for one of the grand final eliminators, which will feature K2 taking on Captain Doom. Captain Doom, you have just defeated Drizzle. How are you feeling about that win?
I'm feeling really good, actually. Yeah, that was an opponent I was very worried about, but then I realized that he's not the fastest robot in the world and I could get to the side.
Excellent. So you're up against K2, the egg beater spinner. Have you got a strategy for this fight?
Definitely. Back at home, these forks are awesome against egg beater slash beater bar spinners. Basically, the strategy is to, they ignore the wedgelet since they're so close together. They get under the beater bar, and when the beater bar hits these claws, they they either fly off or jam up, or sometimes both when they fly off, hit the ground, and then stop.
So you're hoping for another win then? Feeling confident?
I'm feeling pretty confident. I've beaten a lot of egg beaters with this back at home.
Well, good luck, Tyler. And facing Captain Doom, it's K2. K2, you went up against Sore Loser. I bet you're happy about that win.
Yeah, it was good. It was nice to see that K2 was able to make a full 3 minutes reliably. So, yeah, it was good.
So, did you have any repairs after the Sore Loser fight?
Yeah, I lost 2 wheels in the fight, which were easy enough to repair. I just had to change them out and put the clips back on. Also, one of the gearboxes, the teeth on the gears had disappeared. So I changed all four of them. So they're now metal instead of plastic. So that shouldn't be an issue any longer.
What's your strategy for Captain Doom, the feared driver of the competition now?
Seems the last one, I think. Straight at him and just try and stay on top of him.
Good luck, Mark. The robots are ready. Let's get them to the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
Both very fancied machines, these, for the title. Captain Doom taking on its usual tactic of ramming into K2, trying to stop that egg-beating weapon.
The thing is, that egg-beater weapon is actually from America. You can purchase it off the internet. A lot of the robots that Captain Doom will have fought before will have had that weapon. So he's very used to dealing with it. We don't see it as much in the UK. It's not come over here recently.
And what purchase can that egg-beating weapon get on Captain Doom? That's the question now.
Although if you look, that little red thing, that's actually one of the retaining washers from his wheels.
Yeah, you can see one of the wheels on Captain Doom is now out of shape.
K2 appears to be... The weapon appears to have stopped working. I don't know whether he's thrown the pulley or...
Well, it has taken several huge
slams. Oh, no,
it
started up again.
From Captain Doom. And there's another one. You can see the two little waggling forks on the front.
The wheels of Captain Doom have definitely taken a beating.
An egg beating, you might say.
K2 will be looking to try and get into a position where it can... There we go. Oh!
Another massive slam there, and for a second we thought that had killed the drive. Still working.
K2 moving through, getting more and more hits. Oh, a big hit on the front of Captain Doom.
And I think this is the real first big challenge that Captain Doom has had throughout this tournament.
Up until now, Captain Doom's fights have only ever been about 30 seconds long. This is a real test of his ability to stay for a full match.
But also shows we're really up to the best of the best now.
Yeah, message to America, bring it on.
Look at the damage to the wheels.
Ooh. More chunks are coming off the wheels.
Something else has just come flying off.
Oh, he got it out of the arena!
Oh, well.
Using the power of K2's own weapon, he just rammed into him until he bounced himself out of the arena.
Took the knocks. Threw him out.
Well, so you hit him a few times. I think you took out one of his wheels, and then was it the force of your own weapon took you over the wall in the end?
Yeah, because I was running upside down. The weapon spins the wrong way then, so it's sort of flung itself over and out.
But that's the longest anyone's gone with Doom so far in this tournament, so you gotta be pretty happy with that.
Yeah, I took his little caps off. I don't think they do anything with the wheels.
And you're not out completely yet. You've still got the loser's melee, so we could still see you in the semifinals. But we'll go let you get ready for that, because you're going to have to check your bots okay and all that. But everybody, give it up for K2!
All right, Tyler.
You just nothing seems to stop you, does it? That was brilliant. Were you a bit worried when he started taking bits off your robot?
Actually, this is a blade of armor. It's meant to pop off as a second life for the wheel.
Okay, so that was part of your strategy. In case he hit you on the wheels, your wheels are going to stay on?
Yeah, it's better a hub than the entire wheel.
I talked to you before and you said you wanted a bit more of a challenge. Was that more of a challenge for you?
That was the hardest fight yet.
Well, yeah, you've absolutely bulldozed through everybody else. Do you think it's going to keep getting harder from here?
Definitely.
Good, well, we look forward to seeing you in the semifinals. Everybody, Captain Doom!
be surprised if he doesn't have stuff to do. Some real big hits.
I'm just changing the pulley. I've managed to break it, so I need to. But this one that I've got is broken as well.
The bent axle, so we have to replace the entire wheel and the motor.
So I'm here for our eliminator. SED, how do you feel about being in this round?
I think I've had a couple of lucky fights. And now I'm against an opponent that's a favourite, so...
Yeah, there's a bit of controversy with the claws fight, but we worked it out in the end. Yeah. How do you feel about that fight?
I think it was a very, very close call and very difficult to judge in the end. I think I did enough to get through that. We'll see how it goes for the next ones.
You're up against Limpet, which, as you say, is one of the competition favourites. What's your strategy for this?
Hopefully hit them before they hit me, but if they outmaneuver me, obviously I can't move quite so fast. So it'll be down to if they can control me into the pit or something, then maybe not. But if I can hit them hard, maybe me.
Well, good luck, Craig. And now I'm here with Limpet. Limpet, before we talk about the upcoming fight, I would like to see your hair pieces, please. He has got robots in his hair, which is lovely. Why did you do that?
My dad did it.
Oh, blame dad. Right, so you're up against SCD, Melty Brain. What's your strategy for this fight?
Oh, you use a lance to push them in the pit.
Your usual tactic, in the pit. This is the Olympic tactic, in the pit.
Yeah, to ram.
Good luck, guys. The robots are ready. Let's get them in the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
Limpet tactic here, as always, go for the box rush, try and dodge that full body spinner, wait for the pit release tower to be active.
SCD getting up to speed, because SCD doesn't work unless it's spinning first. It's the whole problem with these full body spinners is that they will need to get up to speed first, leaving them vulnerable for the first couple of seconds of spin up.
Limpet certainly getting some great attacks in early on here, ramming SCD into the side walls, using them as its weapon. That lance as well in conjunction. Here comes the pit release. Surely any second now, that's what Limpet's going to be going for, and does so. Down goes the pit. And with SCD, the full body spinner, that's just taking chunks out of Limpet.
The time that Limpet waited for the pit release to be open gave SCD the chance to get up to speed, which has put Limpet in a really bad position now, because he has to risk taking a big hit to the front to try and move SCD, whereas
but
SCD...
using that lance to hockey puck them toward the edge of the pin and down. Fantastic driving. That was absolutely textbook, marvellous display of driving skill.
You got off some big hits in that fight. You took a chunk out of him. You've taken one of his wheels out. But in the end, he got you in the pit, and it's what he's good at. Are you kind of a bit gutted with how it's gone?
No, I'm actually really pleased to get this far in the competition against some wedges which are not really friendly to multi-brain robots. So I'm very pleased to get this far.
Yeah, I mean, you've already beaten two wedges. You couldn't quite make it three in a row. You're not out yet. We do still have the loser's melee for the grand final, so we could be seeing you again in the semi-finals. Is the robot going to be fine for that? It seemed to be working fine when it went in the pit.
I think it'll be fine. I'll check it over, but I think it'll be okay for that.
Wonderful. We look forward to seeing you then. Everybody, give it up for SCD!
Come here, Limpet. Come here.
It wasn't all plain sailing, was it?
Not too bad.
Not too bad? He's taking your wheel off.
Yes, it is.
it was almost like a game of basketball at the end. You flung him towards the pit. He didn't quite go in, and then you got him in at the end. So you got to be happy about that.
Yeah.
Are you still feeling confident that you can win the whole thing?
Yes.
Good, right. Well, we'll see you in the semi-finals of the whole competition. Everybody, give it up for Limpet!
I'm happy to get this far, definitely. Getting some really tough wedges. So, it's done well.
It was a good fight. I really enjoyed that. I mean, I didn't do the driving, jumps, but...
The gearbox is off bushed motors, and I've swapped over Pullman to brushless. It gives us the power and speed.
and we're lasting well. They seem to last better than the old motors. So, I'm pleased with that.
We're ready for another Grand Final Eliminator, which will feature Rev 2 versus Snappy. Felix, comeback of the century. You got defeated by Ogredrive and then you knocked him out in the Heat Final. I bet you're chuffed about that.
It was really good because lost to him in the first fight and then went for the redemption, beat some other robots and then got to sort him out.
You've pulled yourself up through the ranks to get into the Grand Final. You must be feeling so proud.
I'm so happy. I'm really happy. I can keep going.
You're up against Snappy, which is well driven. What's your tactic for Snappy?
He's got a little bit of ground clearance around the side, so hopefully, because I've got the disc on, hopefully go through his wheels. If not, I'm gonna have to try and bend the scoop on the front. It's gonna be tricky though, because he's got a nice wedge, and it's built like a brick. It's gonna be really hard to knock out.
Well, good luck, Felix. And now I'm here with Snappy, and I'm wearing these because of Craig's t-shirt. It's so bright, it's a health and safety issue. Snappy,
hello.
You got your way up through the five-way. That was an amazing battle. I bet you're really happy with that.
Yeah, that was really intense. It could have gone either way. And if it had gone to a judges, I reckon Claws would have had it. So I feel really happy, lucky, and I just want to do my best.
You're up against Rev 2. Got a strategy for this?
Just hit it hard. Like, there's not a lot you can do with this. The same tactic as Mini Spinny, which was a similar robot. We'll just go in, hit his face with my face, see which face breaks first.
Well, good luck, Craig.
Thank you.
Snappy's ready. Let's get it to the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
Now, can that front blade of Snappy negate that undercutting disc? And it certainly can.
So far it
up
can.
Up and over the top.
Rev 2 trying to spin up. If Rev 2 gets in underneath and gets the wheels of Snappy, that will be it.
But they're right, going to have to go for a side on a rear attack. That is if they can move. What on earth has happened to Rev 2?
He's seven, left Rev 2 on his upside down, and Rev 2 stated in his first episode his one weakness is he can't run upside down.
Two, Snappy, what one, did you do? Put a voodoo curse on the arena?
Snappy out of nowhere is pulling an absolute blinder. Could he actually go all the way?
So, well, he got you upside down and it was never going to end any other way if that happened, was it?
Yeah, well, doesn't quite run upside down, but I hadn't been upside down throughout the competition, so I didn't really care about it. So it wasn't saying it was on my mind.
Well, I mean, your spinner got up fine. You just didn't really get a chance to hit him, did you?
Yeah, it was one of those. It's a really fast machine, and I said before, it's got such a nice wedge on it that the teeth can't get a grip on it. It just kind of rides up it and then slam into one and turn me over.
Well, you're going through to the loser's melee for a final chance in the semifinal. You've already come through one of those in your heat. You reckon you can do it again?
Well, it's one too many, really. hopefully. Let's hope so.
All right, we look forward to seeing you in that, everybody. Rev 2! Craig. Yes, you've done it, haven't you? You're in the semi-finals. How does that feel?
I've got three words. It's your boy!
I'm not going to pretend to understand what that means, but we'll go with it. So yeah, that went pretty much according to plan, didn't it?
I had no idea that was going to happen. I thought he could run quite happily upside down, so... A pleasant surprise!
So you're into the semi-finals now, you've come through the Rumble Bee, and you're carrying on, so do you think, are you going to make the final? Are you going to win the final, maybe?
I'm going with the same sentiment I have always gone with. No.
I just love the confidence in these teams. All right, give it up for your boy, this is Snappy!
That went well.
Happy?
Yes, good. No repairs. Charge it up, ready to go.
No repairs, but unfortunately it went upside down. But no, you can do it like that. Well, you can make it run upside down, but it's too easy, isn't it?
We're here for the Redemption Battle, which is a bit of a spin-off. It's featuring SCD, Rev 2, and K2. We'll start with you, Mark. Bit disappointing to lose your last fight, but it was a brilliant fight against Captain Doom, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was really good. Bit disappointed I've flung myself out. So I was like, oh.
But you were the first out of the arena, though, so you've got to take that home.
Yeah, that's true.
So are you ready for the redemption melee? Hopefully you can get back in the competition.
Hopefully.
Good luck, Mark. Thank you. Felix, you ready for the redemption melee?
Yeah, it's all in.
You could try and sound a bit more enthusiastic. Come on, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah. SCD, you've been doing really well. Bit gutted to be knocked out, but one more chance. You ready for this fight?
I'm ready for this. I think this is going to be very interesting.
I think there's going to be lots of damage in this fight with three spinners. Are you prepared for that?
Hopefully. We'll see how it goes.
Good luck, guys. Good luck to everyone. The robots are ready. Let's get them in the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
Interesting mix of spinners here. All three of these machines with that particular type of weapon, but different styles as they come smashing together. There's SCD taking a knock against K2 there.
Rev 2 with the big undercutter, trying to get to the wheels of his opponent.
Oh, massive slam there.
K2 taking a big hit there from SCD, pinballed across the arena once again.
There's SCD spinning up to speed there in the bottom corner of the arena as K2 and Rev 2 come into contact with one another.
Enabled.
That's the pit release tower enabled. That's what K2 seems to be going for as Rev 2 takes a slam there in the bottom corner from SCD. The pit release tower has been activated. Down goes the pit.
K2 hanging back there. Appears to have lost his weapon.
Another massive attack there as SCD goes flying across the arena. I think that was Rev 2 that smashed into the side of it.
Rev 2 may have done as much damage to itself, though. If you look, it's no longer driving properly on one side and takes another big hit from SCD. SCD just getting spun up, and once it gets spinning, you'll notice those lights in the corner to help work out which way's the front.
Ooh! Bunched away there, almost ending up in the pit. Lack of control, perhaps, here could seal their fate.
And SCD's out!
Pushes them down and out.
SCD out of the competition. We're down to two. K2 and Rev 2.
Sparks beginning to fly there, but what's happened with Rev 2 here? Oh, no, they're free.
Rev 2 having difficulty moving across the floor. This could either be a drive problem, or it could just be it's taken some hits from the side from SCD, and it's risen one of the wheels up just enough to make it difficult for it to move.
Oh, it's like going 16 rounds with Conor McGregor. He's got no legs left on him.
K2 weaponless. Its only weapon now is just the power of that four-wheel drive system. K2's bar has been disabled for a very long time in this fight.
Rev 2, with that lack of drive, K2 is using the force of those knocks from Rev 2's blade to send it spiraling towards the pit. Surely, any second now, they're on the edge, there they go!
K2 surviving the loser's melee to come back and make it for a place in the finals.
The egg beater beating all.
Hopefully he can repair it before he has to fight next.
Right, so when you got your bar out of the arena, you were quite shocked at the damage that your robot's taken. So do you mind telling me what's happened? What's happened to SCD?
Well, it wasn't so much the damage. It was the fact it was making a siren noise, which it's never done before.
Did you program it to make a siren noise?
No. That's what worries me. But also the link appears to have broken as well. So
you could have gone out earlier.
Possibly, yeah. It looks like the wire's loose, so it was held in by tape, basically.
Wow. Well, you ended up in the pit. You were first to go. Did you feel maybe it was a bit of a tough matchup against two spinners who move across the arena faster than you?
Yeah, absolutely. They've got much better maneuverability on me, so they were likely to pit me before I could do any real significant damage.
Well, so that's you. You're out of the competition now. Has it been a good one for you?
It's been fantastic.
Excellent. Right, give it up for SCD! You hung on in there. You only had one wheel for most of that, didn't you? And you managed to keep your spinner facing him, but in the end, he got you in the pit. That was quite a fight, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty hard to avoid the pit with only one-wheel drive.
Did the spinner work as well as you thought it was going to?
Yeah, it spun pretty freely. Before the fight, I was having trouble with tensioning it.
But well, it worked fine, and you got off some good hits, and you lasted longer than SCD did. So that's the end of the competition for you. Are you happy with how you've done? You've come the hard way. You came through the loser's melee in your heat, but you got this far. So you got to be pretty proud, haven't you?
Oh yeah, I'm very, very pleased with how it's gone. Say this is the second loser's melee I've been in. So yeah, it's gone really well. I'm really happy.
Excellent. It's been great having you, everybody. Rev 2. Yes, you've done it. Yeah. You took you in a fight with three spinners. You won it with a spinner that wasn't working. So yeah, that's you've got to be proud of that at least.
Yeah, it was great. It would have been better with a spinner, but you know you've got to make do with now.
Yeah, you got them both in the pit. That was excellent driving. Do you reckon you're going to have the spinner fixed in time for your semi-final?
I hope so, because I think it's just that bit of plastic there is holding the weapon back, stopping it from moving. So if that's the case, then yeah, we'll change the battery and we're good to go.
Excellent. Well, you've had your redemption. You're back in the semi-finals. Are we going to see you in the final?
I hope so.
Good. We'd love to see you there. Thank Everybody you. Give it up for K2! So there we have it. We have all four of our semi-finalists, but only one of them is going to be the Bugglebots champion. I cannot wait.
I broke a link, which is always fun. So that came out, and it started beeping some weird error code when it came out of the pit. So who knows?
It went alright. Didn't take that much damage. Well, gearbox got knocked out of place, but that was quite an easy result there. It was bad damage, but it was just like, and it's done.
That's good.
Good fight. It's alright.
Did you win?
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yay. Yeah. My weapon stopped working, so I literally had to like use the front of it just to like poke
Did
people in.
Did you explode another pulley?
No, I think there's a bit of plastic that's jammed up the weapon, so I literally nose pointed both of them in the pit.
We're ready for a semi-final match, which is a battle of the pushers. It's Limpet versus Captain Doom. John, Tyler with Captain Doom is an amazing driver. Are you a little bit worried about this fight?
The Americans are a bit worried. Amazing, America.
Have you got a strategy for this fight, or is it going to be the usual put him in the pit?
Put him in the pit, I guess. It's very fast.
It is very fast. John, are you worried about this fight?
Not really. I've been dying to see it all weekend. As soon as I found out he was a good driver and that, and he was top American, I thought, we've got to beat them.
So you've been looking forward to this fight all weekend then?
Yeah, definitely. If we hadn't met him in the fight, we'd have had a grudge match. So,
excellent. Well, good luck to you both. And now I'm back here with Captain Doom. You're up against Limpet, which was one of the favourite picks for this competition. How are you feeling about this one, Tyler?
More nervous than the other one. This one's probably going to last either the full 3 minutes or one of us is going to end up in the pit. Hopefully not me.
Well, you had an amazing fight against K2. That was a little bit more difficult than your previous fights, though, wasn't it?
Definitely. It bent the axle, which is why we had to make a lot of repairs to it. Damaged the axle a lot.
Oh, dear. And you had some wheel damage as well from K2?
Well, the wheel damage was cosmetic. This is the blade of armor. It's supposed to give the wheels a second life by popping off, and the wheel act stays on.
Amazing. Well, good luck for your fight against Limpet. The robots are ready. Let's get them to the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
These incredibly powerful pushing machines! Oh, look at that for an impact!
Right at the start.
Limpet
overcharging into the front of it.
Oh! Off comes a wheel!
The wheel from Captain Doom has come off right at the start.
And does that in fact spell their doom?
We will find out later on. But this is handicapping Captain Doom because it's now got much less traction than its opponent Limpet.
How on earth did that wheel come off? I guess we'll find out after this battle, but for now, it's definitely put them on the back foot.
Limpet is still on the back foot though, because Captain Doom, despite only being on three wheels, is driving into the front of Limpet like an absolute boss. He's giving it no quarter.
Making such good use of those front prongs there.
The pit release button has been hit. This favours Limpet, and he's used to operating with a pit. Captain Doom normally fights in America where there isn't a pit option.
He's certainly giving it a good go there, giving it a good hard push toward Oblivion.
Oh, Limpet dodging out again. Limpet upside down. So his wedge is actually a hindrance at the moment because it's riding up on top of Captain Doom.
Great driving here by Limpet thus far. Although they are upside down, that scoop ineffective. Oh,
no!
Oh, Captain Doom on the edge of the pit of unbelievable victory for Limpet.
Limpet securing its place in the grand final of Bugglebots.
Tyler, that was an amazing fight, wasn't it? You were still pushing around with only three wheels. What happened to the fourth one?
K2 shadowed the inside of it, so it wasn't fitting on right.
Oh well, that's a shame. But you were driving like crazy, even with three wheels. That's amazing, right?
Kinda. I don't even know what. Yeah, K2 shadowed the inside of it, so in a way, K2 did win technically, along with one pit.
But you've made it. You made it to the semifinals of Bugglebots, and you were on top for a lot of that fight. Do you think maybe if you'd got a bit more luck, you might have won through?
I think I would have had a better chance if the wheel hadn't been shattered.
Well, that's the way it goes sometimes. It's been an absolute joy having you. Are you going to stick around for a third, fourth place playoff?
I'll stick around.
All right, excellent. It's been absolutely wonderful having you. There we go. That's how much they love you. Come on, give it up for Captain Doom! Limpet, that was quite a hard fight, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
He got you upside down straight off the bat, and he was still pushing you with three wheels. Can you imagine? If he'd had four, do you think he'd have beaten you?
Yes.
But you got him in the pit, didn't you?
Yes.
Is that what you're going to do in the final?
Yes.
I like you. You give short answers. This is great. Can we give it up for your first grand finalist, Limpet?
K2 probably got a bit loose, and his spike finished the job by prying it off. Normally, it wouldn't have fallen off like that, and I wouldn't have desperately pushed the pit button in the hope for a pit.
No damage at all. We were lucky.
I am here with your boy Craig, who just defeated Rev2 and is now in the semi-final with K2. How are you feeling about your win?
It was a really good fight, yeah. Tipped it over, couldn't get back up, left it alone, had a little victory dance.
Bit of a surgical win, that one.
It was a little bit, yeah. A bit lucky, but no, it was a good win.
So you're up against K2, the beta spinner. Got a strategy for this one?
Same strategy as always, sadly. Rams into it and hope I get under it. It's a vicious spinner.
So. It's been very effective this season. Are you a bit cautious of this fight then?
Yeah, this is the spinner that I've faced that I'm most worried about.
Well, good luck, Craig. And now I'm with Mark and K2. Mark, you're up against Snappy, which is a wedge, which is kind of the nemesis of the spinners. So how are you feeling about this one?
Nervous. And Craig's really good as well.
Craig is a very good driver, so you're going into this one pretty cautiously then.
I wouldn't say that. We'll see.
Or are you going into it confidently?
Well, yeah, I've made the repairs that needed to be done, I think, so it should just be working now as it was in all the other fights.
Well, good luck, Mark. Good luck, K2. The robots are ready. Let's get them in the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
I think the speed and the effectiveness of that wedge is going to spell doom for K2.
K2 is going to want to get a good purchase on the side of Snappy and use that beater.
It's been a mountainous run for K2 thus far, but is it going to come to a close now?
Doesn't seem to have the power that it had before.
Ooh, ramming that egg-beating weapon into the sidewall there. Snappy. Definitely the aggressor here.
Snappy using tactics, trying to keep K2 to the front and not give him a chance to get down to the rear where his armor is much thinner than at the front.
Oh, Snappy taking a hit there from the egg beater.
But then getting right back underneath. Beautiful aggression.
And once again, and it's hard to tell if that's the flipper firing or if that's in fact the flipper taking hits, taking uppercuts
from the egg-beating weapon of K2.
Oh, and a big hit, flipping Snappy over.
Well, I guess that's answered my question.
K2 there, but has K2 lost the weapon, or has he just powered it down to push?
Who knows at this point? And are Snappy lulling them into a false sense of security?
This may become a driver's game, as K2 may have lost a weapon, but Snappy being upside down makes it much harder.
Oh, K2! They've fallen into the trap! Oh, look at them! Desperately fighting it!
This is turning into a more attrition, both pulling away from the pit after very nearly Snappy putting K2 in.
Who has got the stronger drive? Who's got the stronger pushing power? And certainly with Snappy inverted, it's looking like K2 has found a weak spot.
Both seem to be very evenly matched in pushing power. K2 might have the slight advantage, mainly due to the traction of the wheels. But Snappy, if he is spinning up again, K2 getting that weapon going.
Oh.
He may be looking for an out of the arena with what similar to what happened to himself with Captain Doom.
Those bright, lurid green lights on the underside of Snappy. My eyes hurt.
Oh! K2 driving Snappy backwards into the pit.
K2, the victor. What a surprising victory.
Hard luck, but once he got you upside down, was that curtains, basically?
Yeah, pretty much. He knows once I'm upside down, I'm not a problem anymore. So he left the weapon off, and good tactic, you know.
He did what you wanted to do to him, really. He put you in the pit.
Yeah, that's fair play to him. That was awesome driving and a really fun match. So,
I mean... So next up, you're going to be in the third place playoff. You're up against Young Tyler and Captain Doom, so you're looking forward to that.
Yeah.
you don't sound convinced at all.
Yeah, Tyler's an incredible driver. I think we all know that. So,
yeah. So if you were offered fourth place now, would you take it?
Well, I think that's what's going to happen. So.
You've made it to the semifinals. You've got to be pretty proud of how your robots stood up to all that.
It's been incredible. I can't complain at all.
Excellent. Right. You've been a great sport throughout. Thank Give it up for Craig and Snappy! Yay!
Right.
I heard you remark during that fight that the spinner was working. You just turned it off. Why did you do that?
I prefer to fight him upside down. So, and I didn't want people thinking, you know, if it went the distance... The weapon was broke when it was, and it was just I knocked it off because I wanted to push him in the pit.
I mean, you did that with the spinner on in the end.
Yeah, I did in the end, yeah, because I wasn't pushing him in the pit. So
you've come through a loser's melee where it was you and two other spinners. Yeah. You took some big hits. You've just taken out Snappy. You're in the Bugglebots final. You're up against Limpet. Yeah. Do you think you can take them?
I don't know. I've versed it before. But yeah, I don't see why not.
So it's shaping up to be a spectacular grand final. Can you all give it up for your second grand finalist, K2? So in the grand final, it's the fearsome wedge of Limpet against the egg beater of K2. But first, we've got to have a third place playoff. So let's get to that.
Oh, that didn't go as planned. Not a lot of damage. Again, it's pretty unscathed, just the superficial stuff. So I'm going to mess it around a little bit, get it ready for the next fight.
Managed to get a couple of big hits in, flipped him over. I knocked the weapon off to try and push him in the pits. Didn't really work, so I put the weapon on, give him a few hits, and then managed to push him in the pit. So, happy days.
We are ready for the playoff for third place, which is between Snappy and Captain Doom. Snappy, you lost to K2. Are you a bit gutted?
A little bit. It would have been nice to get into that final, so I definitely had a trophy. But we ended up taking a load of damage. So,
what damage did you take from K2?
So K2 somehow ruined one of the gearboxes on these motors. So I've just spent the last 10 minutes getting that out, getting a new one in. And getting it all back together, and it seems okay now. Everything else is just cosmetic, so we should have a good fight.
You're up against Doom Kid. Do you think that's going to be a repeat of your fight with Limpet, or do you think he did lose to Limpet, so maybe you've got it in the bag?
Tyler's an amazing driver. I know he won't go for the pit because that's not his style. I will, because I'm British. It could go like I think he's got it, and I think we all know he's probably got it. But it'll be a fun fight. I'm really looking forward to being able to fight with someone so renowned. You know, I think it's going to be great fun.
Well, good luck, Craig. And now I'm here with Captain Doom. Tyler, you went up against Limpet, which was a brutal fight. How are you feeling about it?
Like, our axle got cracked in the previous fight. And we went up against Limpet, not knowing, because the damage is hidden. So, yeah, it would have been a much different fight. Probably would have lasted the full 3 minutes, because I wouldn't have tried desperately to pit and not realized I couldn't pit because I had only 3 wheels.
Okay, you're up against Snappy. He's a pretty good driver. Maybe not as scary as Limpet, though. How are you feeling about playing off for third place? Think you're going to get it?
Well, I did good against Limpet, and Limpet beat Snappy, so pretty confident.
Good luck, Tyler. The robots are ready. Let's get them to the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
This for the bronze medal, and Captain Doom wants a medal of any description at this point. They are not giving Snappy a chance.
Snappy doing one for the UK. Snappy is regularly coming fourth and fifth in these sort of competitions. So for him to go home with a third place would be very well received for Craig Croucher.
It's not looking likely at the moment. Captain Doom controlling this fight, ramming Snappy into every single arena sidewall that it can throw it at.
Snappy seeming to struggle to get underneath the forks of Captain Doom. They're very well designed for fighting a full one.
Oh, flipped up and over there.
Captain Doom now inverted. He's tried to hit Snappy, tried to hit the pit release button, but didn't get it.
There we go.
There's the pit now.
Down it comes, bottom corner of your picture, as the two machines rock and roll. Back and forth, heave-ho across the arena floor.
The key thing you have to remember is Captain Doom's not used to fighting with a central pit in the middle of the arena. American arenas don't have that, so this is a feature he's not used to having to avoid. But
he's adapting, he's learning,
and
down
he's done
goes
it.
Snappy. A third place on the podium goes to Little Taylor and Captain Doom.
The Doom Kid from the invading Niles has overcome odds to get third place.
So, Craig, it's been a long road for you. You came through the five-way, the Rumble Bee, and you made it to the semifinals. You've gone out, but now and you've come fourth overall. Are you happy with your overall performance in the end?
It's been insane. That fight was amazing. All the fights I've had have been, you know, world-class stuff. I'm so proud of the machine, and I'm overwhelmingly so happy for Tyler.
He's done fantastically, hasn't he? You know, he's only 9 years old. He's come in. And I think he's schooled a lot of you older guys on how to drive, I think.
I couldn't have lost to a better kid, you know.
Oh, that's amazing, right? Fantastically gracious in defeat. Give it up for Snappy! There you have it. You've come third in Bugglebots on your first attempt. How does that feel?
It actually feels pretty good.
I mean, I'd like to think so. Did you think you had him quiet at the end? You got him in the pit nice and easy?
Some reason, when the pit's activated, my forks somehow get easier to escape.
Yeah, well, they didn't escape this time, did he? And you did the job?
No. I used the pit because one of my forks was stuck up in his flippers, so I could easily push him to the pit.
Right, excellent. Well, you've been fantastic throughout. I mean, everyone here has been absolutely gobsmacked by how great you've been. There's someone else I want to bring in, though. We want to kind of give you a special mention on camera, because you've flown all the way from America with a fractured foot to support Tyler. Like, how proud are you of your boy and what he's achieved?
Oh, super proud. He's the very best, and he wants to get better. He never settles.
That's quite scary for everyone else, I think, if he's going to get better. Yeah. Here to present you with your third place trophy, we've got Sarah. So there we are. Third place in the inaugural Bugglebots. Give it up for Tyler and Captain Doom! All right. Without further ado, we've got a championship to settle.
We are ready for the grand final, and I am here with Limpet. Captain Doom was a pretty tough opponent for you, though, wasn't it, John?
Yes, it is.
That was a really tough fight. I mean, his wheel came off, and I think ultimately that gave you the advantage. But were you pretty nervous going into that battle?
Not nervous.
But it went the way you wanted, and that's a good thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're up against K2, nasty beta spinner. What's going to be your tactic with this one?
Well, the tactic is use this stick thing.
John, have you made any modifications for this fight?
Not for this one. We've kept the lance because it's got an active weapon, so it keeps it able to keep it at bay. But otherwise, it's just the standard robot.
All right. Good luck, guys. And now I'm here with K2. Mark, did you think when you came to Bugglebots that you would be in the grand final?
No. The best I've placed in the past has been top 10, and that's about it. So yeah.
You've not been doing beetles that long, have you?
No, since last October, so less than a year.
What's your strategy for Limpet?
Same again, I'm just going to hit him. I'm just going to hit him until something stops.
Not got any other sneaky plans up your sleeve?
To be honest, I don't think I'm going to be able to get around him because he's just too fast. So I think he's going to dictate the speed of the fight, but I'm just going to hit him as much as I can.
Well, good luck, Mark. The robots are ready. Let's get them to the arena.
Roboteers, get ready. Three, two, one, begin.
So it all comes down to this. Limpet versus K2. K2 has themselves flipped up on the side, crashes down again.
K2's very nearly to getting stuck on the side there. Lucky to fall the right way and get his wheels down to pull itself off. Limpet staying onto them, not giving them a chance to get any hits in or get any bearings.
For me, Limpet is just taking their time here until that pit release button becomes active, and then it's a case of trying to control K2 toward the corner of the arena and push them into the pit.
Limpet using its drive power there to use the sidewalls to batter K2 to death and going straight for the pit release button.
This is the tactic.
K2 driving over Limpet there. Limpet almost too low to be useful and damaging the lance.
We know the driving skill of John Denny Jr. We know the power of Limpet. We know K2 is on the back foot. We know that they can avoid that egg-beating weapon. They're ramming them into the corner there, Limpet. Here comes the lineup. Oh, almost had them into the pit.
The important thing to remember is K2 has come back from losing points on more than one occasion this competition, and that weapon, just one good hit, could cause a major issue. Oh!
Massive slam there into our pit release tire, and once again,
K2's been righted. That works so much in its favour now, because it'll hopefully be able to turn over Limpet, which could change the direction of this fight entirely. K2 getting underneath Limpet now.
Is it just me, or is Limpet looking a little slow here, a little sluggish? Limpet flipped up and over, and dancing around the edge of that pit. What an upset it would be.
Driving skill of epic proportions from both teams here. K2 turning off the beater now, similar to what they did to Snappy.
Yep, once again, making sure that Limpet don't accidentally get knocked back the right way up.
The key you have to remember is now Limpet's wedge is basically useless. So all it's going to be doing is lifting itself onto the front of K2 and making this an easy fight for K2. Limpet will want to use the back of its robot like it's doing there to push into K2 and force it a drive thing, because Limpet will have a far more powerful drivetrain than K2.
I tell you what, for a grand final fight, this has been absolutely wild, desperate all together, as the two machines are just sort of hanging on with each other now.
We are perched on the edge of our seats watching this, ladies and gentlemen. This could be anyone's fight at any second. K2 spinning up its weapon again, trying to earn damage points.
And Limpet very much worn down now, not as impressive as it was whenever this fight first began.
Limpet definitely flagging.
The two of these war-weary machines. And what a great story it's been for both of them. As the last 10 seconds of our grand final counts down, it's going to the judges.
This could be one of the toughest decisions the judges will have ever had to make in this entire competition. It's gone to the time limit. We have to leave it to the judges. I don't know who won that. I don't know about you, Stephen.
Honestly, Alistair, toss a coin.
I wouldn't want to be the judges in this position. I wouldn't want to call it. Beautiful fight from both teams there.
Firstly, wow. That was a worthy final, I think we will all agree. So before we talk to anybody, can we have a massive round of applause for what an amazing fight that was? The first portion of the fight, that was kind of yours, wasn't it? You were pushing him around, you were taking the hits from the spinner. You got him upside down. Did you think you maybe had him a couple of times against the wall?
Yeah, I thought we got him at one point on the pit button. I thought he was stuck, but John Connolly knocked him off. We're carried on.
Oh, he's shown that the whole way, hasn't he? His ability to just get out of scrapes like that, hasn't he? It's a fantastic robot, isn't it?
Yeah, we certainly had a work cut out trying to beat that one. It's a good robot.
I mean, that's the first time you've been taking the distance, isn't it?
I think so.
So there's merit enough in that, isn't there? So are you happy with how it's gone? You've got to the final. Obviously, it's in the hands of the judges at this point. But are you happy with it?
Yeah, really pleased. I mean, it's been a great weekend. New robot, I didn't know how to work. It worked superb, so.
Excellent. Right, give it up for Limpet! Now, Mark, I spied some parallels with your fight with Snappy. Once you got him upside down, you powered the spinner down again. You like fighting robots that are upside down, don't you?
Well, it's easier. You know, the whole purpose of a wedge is to get under you, but obviously if it's reversed, then that's out the window. So, and now with four-wheel drive, you know, it's more competitive.
Did you think he had you when you were upside down?
I was very nervous, but I was driving it without turning it upside down, so that was an improvement on the last time I was upside down. But yeah, it was definitely more difficult when I was upside down.
You had a couple of close shaves with the pit, didn't you?
Yes.
But the important thing is you stayed out of it, yeah. And it's going to go to the judges. Yeah. But before we get to that, can we have a big hand for K2, please? So the judges have made their decision. They have been judging on control, damage, and aggression. And before I announce this, Head Judge Kane wanted me to tell that this is the closest decision that they have had to make over the whole competition. The decision was, however, unanimous. And the inaugural Bugglebots champion is...
K2!
Commiserations to Limpet. It was a great fight, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was close.
I mean, you fought so hard and so well, and you know, you fought right to the last. So, can we have a massive round of applause for your Bugglebots runners-up, Limpet? You did it! You've been through a lot. You've come out of a lot of scrapes along the way there, but you're the Bugglebots champion. How does that feel?
Amazing.
That was fantastic. You've been brilliant. The crowd have definitely taken to you. And so we're going to have to see you back because now you've got a title to defend. Is that a target on your back next time we're here?
Yeah, but we'll see what happens. Are you...
A fully deserved victory. You've been a true gladiator throughout. Can we have a round of applause for the inaugural Bugglebots champion, K2! It's been an amazing tournament from start to finish. We've proven that good things really do come in small packages. Thank you for watching Bugglebots!
In the pit! In the pit! In the pit!